The leading actress whose career has survived the Hollywood potholes of addiction, overpublicized marriages, and sometimes ill-chosen projects. Melanie Griffith is one such individual whose journey to fame began when the actress was exposed to the pressures of celebrity life right from the very beginning. Many years later, the starlet would survive a lion mauling, a car accident, a series of broken relationships, and a battle with alcoholism. Indeed, her success is presumably all the sweeter for the incredible challenges she has managed to overcome. How'd she do it? Follow this video to the end, smash the subscribe button for 7 years of good luck, and comment "I subscribed," and we'll try our best to get back to you. She was born Melanie Richards Griffith. Born on August 9, 1957 in Manhattan, New York City to actress Tippi Hedren and Peter Griffith, a former child stage actor and advertising executive. During her childhood and adolescent years, Melanie Richards Griffith lived part of the time in New York with her father and part-time in Antelope Valley, California, where her mother formed the animal preserve Shambhala. Griffith appeared in advertisements and briefly worked as a child model before abandoning the career, citing extreme shyness as the reason. While attending Hollywood Professional School, Griffith was advanced in her studies, which allowed her to skip a grade level and graduated at age 16. She was only 4 years old when her father left the family. Melanie was only 2 years old when her parents separated, after which she relocated to Los Angeles with her mother. They divorced 2 years later when her Griffith was 4. After divorcing Hedren, her father married model and actress Nanita Green and had 2 more children, Tracy Griffith, who also became an actress, and Clay A. Griffith, a set designer. Her mother later got married to agent and producer Noel Marshall when Griffith was 7 years old. She had her first major role at age 17. In 1975, Melanie had her first major role at the age of 17 in Arthur Penn's film noir, Night Moves, in which she portrayed a runaway teenager pursued across the United States by a private detective, Gene Hackman. In the film, she controversially appeared on screen nude in several scenes. Griffith's performance in Night Moves drew attention to her, and she was subsequently cast in 2 1975 films, The Comedy Smile, playing a pageant contestant, and Stuart Rosenberg's The Drowning Pool, a thriller in which she portrayed the daughter of a Louisiana woman, Joanne Woodward, involved in a criminal investigation. She was also named Miss Golden Globe for 1975, helping out at the Golden Globe Awards. Rise to stardom. Griffith achieved her mainstream success when Mike Nichols cast her as spunky secretary Tess McGill in the 1988 box office hit Working Girl, co-starring Harrison Ford, Joan Cusack, Alec Baldwin, and Sigourney Weaver. Noted for her performance and her eagerness to break out of her clerical rut and her tenacity in dealing with whoever seems to be thwarting her, Griffith was nominated for an Academy Award for Best Actress and won a Golden Globe Award for Best Actress in a Musical or Comedy. The film marked a professional shift for Griffith, earning her accolades as an A-list actress. She struggled with alcohol and drug addiction since she was a teenager. While the film, directed by Mike Nichols and also starring Sigourney Weaver and Harrison Ford, was a breakthrough role for Griffith and hailed as one of the first believable representations in the decade of excess, the making of the film would also mark the first time Griffith would seriously face her ongoing substance abuse issues, due largely in part to a day on set which she would later recall as a humbling, embarrassing experience, and would result in her checking into rehab 3 weeks after the shoot. Before then, alcohol and drug abuse was an issue that Griffith has battled since her teenage years in Hollywood. She reportedly remembers drinking wine as early as age 10 and told Vanity Fair in 1994 that she was not apologetic about the years when her days would begin with vodka and end with cocaine. "I didn't get some things I needed when I was little. I was never loved unconditionally. Coke, booze, gives you a feeling, a physical sensation, a buzz inside your body that takes the place of something you should have had as a child," Melanie Griffith. She married 4 times to 3 actors. Melanie met her first love when she was just 14. She met 22-year-old actor Don Johnson on the set of the Herod Experiment, and the two moved in together almost immediately and wedded 3 years later. The marriage didn't last long, but their relationship would become an enduring saga, fit for the big screen. Later that year, they both fought battles with addiction, and while their love for each other was profound, it was perhaps because they had so much in common that a family life together proved impossible. Melanie eventually filed for divorce in 1996 after both spent time at rehab centers. Griffith regained control of her life when she began dating actor Stephen Bower, whom she met on the set of the 1981 TV movie She's in the Army Now, and they moved to New York together. Living with Bower in New York, Griffith sobered up and began taking acting classes under Stella Adler. However, Griffith and Bower divorced in 1987, and she returned to a life of alcoholism and drug addiction. Eventually, she checked into the Hazelden Addiction Treatment Center in Minnesota. After leaving rehab, Griffith reunited with ex-husband Don Johnson. They remarried in 1989, and in October of that year, Griffith gave birth to their daughter, Dakota. However, after Johnson indulged in several well-publicized bouts of drunkenness and infidelity, the couple divorced again in 1996. While the years that followed brought mixed fortunes professionally, she later met a man who would change her life. Melanie first set eyes on Antonio Banderas on the set of Too Much in 1996. The pair fell deeply in love, and later that year were married. Stella, their daughter, was born just a few months afterward. Her relationship with the hunky Spaniard seemed to mark a turnaround in her professional life too, as performances in films like Lolita and Celebrity brought renewed respect from the critics. Sadly, in 2014, her marriage to Antonio ran into trouble and she filed for divorce. The couple said they were separating in a loving and friendly manner. She was attacked by a lion while filming. Outside of her relationship, there were other problems. In 1980, she was hit by a car and badly injured when crossing Sunset Boulevard while intoxicated. She was hospitalized again the following year after being attacked by a lion during the filming of her mother's big cat feature, Roar. On both occasions, she recovered, and while further trials lay ahead, success and happiness were also on their way. Later in life, although Griffith had landed her dream role, her substance abuse issues made the filming process a difficult one for her. Addiction returned to haunt her, however, and in 2000, Melanie checked into a clinic in Florida to be treated for painkiller dependency. It's a battle that never ends, and you just have to take it one day at a time, just like they say, she says. But you need help from a higher power. After several tumultuous relationships and repeated struggles with alcoholism and drug addiction, Griffith is living a healthy lifestyle, and once again enjoying consistent acting work. Do you agree with our picks? Let's hear your thoughts about Melanie Griffith in the comments below. And if you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and subscribe for more of our celebrity videos. Until we meet again, don't stop watching, guys.